Hey there, good afternoon, Derby fans around the world. I'm Andrew Marone. I'm joined by Shady Hawkins here to my right, your left on the TV screen. Thank you so much for joining us today. Coming up to the conclusion of the first installment of the 2016 Wftda International Division II playoffs, hosted by ICT Rollergirls. We are here in Wichita, Kansas. Today, we've got the, we've got the third place bout going the Jet City Roller Girls, our number one seed, ranked 42 in the WFTDA out of Everett, Washington. They will be taking on the three seed, ranked 46 in the world, the Nashville Roller Girls. They will be wearing white today, the first time they've been able to don the white jerseys. Kind of how we got here, followed both teams. Coming in as the one seed, they had the automatic bye Friday to Jet City. They held on very late, but they still held on, Shady, to defeat Boulder County 175-160. And then Saturday afternoon, they fell after an attempted comeback against Brandywine 198-170. That loss puts them into the third place game, which we're about to see here. Nashville on the other side of things, a thrilling, one of many thrilling games we've had here this weekend, Shady, defeating Tucson on the final jam 152-149. They then went on to lose a tough game to Blue Ridge 178-133. Sets up the game we have now between the 1 and 3 seeds, Jet City and Nashville. Rosters, Shady, please.
Absolutely. Let's go ahead and meet these teams again. In blue, Jet City is going to be 1 C, you wouldn't want to be a 10 LNZ, 12 Nasty Nikki Nightstick, 13 The Mexorcist, 19 Kat Von Devious, 2 Simon LeBomb, 21 Rock and Roll Achola, 22 Shock Stopper, 39 Woe Nelly, 44 Singria, number 5 Ivana Hercha, 6 Razor Wrecker, 80 Beethoven's Fist, and 87 Alia Smasha. Whereas in white for Nashville Roller Girls, Music City All-Stars will be 027 Cold Hearted, 11 Polly Pushy Pants, 1976 Electric Boogaloo, 220 Electric Cal, 226 Tarot Bite, 48 Phantom Power, 515 Cruella LaVille, 53 Lady Fury, 7 Ramona DeFlowers, 718 Incredible Hull, 757 Morgan Levy, 867 Evil Mendez, 868 Zip Drive, and 912 Gnarly Quinn.
30 seconds away here. What's keys to victory?
Keys to victory for both of these teams, I think, is going to be who can play the longest, most consistent game of this game. Both of these teams are struggling a little bit with consistency, so I think whoever has been able to kind of harness that and can do it both periods, not just the first period, not just the second period, but both periods, is going to come away with this one.
Yeah, we were kind of talking about it earlier before the tournament started today. You know, a lot of these teams in Division II, and especially the lower portion of Division I, kind of have that Jekyll and Hyde mentality. They'll play amazingly great derby, you know, for 30 minutes, and then all of a sudden something just quits clicking, and all of a sudden, you know, things start to fall apart. So, like you said, we'll see who can play the most consistent game here today.
First jam of the game is going to feature Zip Drive for Nashville. She's going to be skating alongside Woe Nelly for Jet City Bombers. And it's going to be Woe Nelly taking the outside line, earning lead jammer status first this game.
Trying to push her way through the middle to begin right off the jam start. Eventually found some nice breathing room to the outside of turn one.
And they're going to reach the back of the pack. Zip Drive still trailing back behind. But Woe Nelly trying to whip off of one of her blockers, that shock stopper. On the outside, she was met by a Nashville blocker. She'll go ahead and call it off. 2 points, first points of the game on the board, Nashville.
2016,
Jet City.
2000 International WFTDA Championship tickets go on sale tomorrow, folks. August 22nd on Monday. Be a champion VIP. Get your VIP tickets and champs for only $125. Three-day VIP ticket includes reserve seating in the best seats of the house, collector's program, and a badge and lanyard.
I'm so used to seeing Nashville wearing those blue jerseys. A little tripped up there for a moment, but it's going to be Alia Smasha for Jet City in blue and Lady Fury for Nashville in white. And it is Alia Smasha, two in a row now for Jet City, lead jammer. Track cut issued to the Nashville jammer, Lady Fury. Lady Fury going to take a seat in the penalty box. Power jam now, opportunity for Jet City.
Lady Fury be the last game she skates for the Nashville All-Stars. Music City All-Stars, I apologize. She's got emblazoned across the backside of her pants today. Check you later.
So apropos, Alia Smasha, first scoring pass already on the board with a second one coming up. 5 more points for Alia Smasha. Quiet pack there in turn number 2. Not a lot of offense played there, but wasn't really necessary. Alia Smashia coming across to the inside line, able to make her way through. Third scoring pass, 5 additional points, Jet City. Again, she tries that lateral movement across to the front to the inside. This time, Nashville ready for her, forcing her to recycle on the inside. Now with a star stash, Lady Rider, having returned to the track, is able to make her initial pass. Alia Smasha sees her coming, goes ahead, calls it off. 4 more points on the board now. 19-point jam, Jet City.
Lady Rider skating for Blue Ridge this weekend. That is Lady Fury.
Lady Fury. Thank you.
Yeah, on that power jam, I didn't see, like you said, we didn't see a whole lot of offense. We also didn't see a whole lot of communication. So maybe it was something they had already planned ahead of time, but not a whole lot of communication going on so far between our two packs.
That was something that they were struggling with, though, so hopefully we'll start to see that take shape later on. Meanwhile, on the Fast Girl Skate start line, number 5 for Jet City, Ivana Hercha, and number 7, Ramona D. Flowers in the white for Nashville. And it's Ramona D. Flowers up at the front of the pack now, with Ivana Hercha pushed to the outside, forced to recycle. Now on the inside, Ramona D. Flowers forced to recycle. But she's going to take the front position in the pack, but it's the outside line left open for Ivana Hercha, lead jammer again for Jet City.
That's 3 lead designations in a row for the visits from Everett, Wisconsin, Everett, Washington.
Ivana Hercha going to go ahead and call the jam off, getting those points, calling it, feeling the pressure from Nashville's jammer, Ramona D. Flowers.
I'm sure there's an Everett in Wisconsin. Jet City is not from there, though.
No. Number 19, Kat Von Devious, going to go ahead and step up to the line this time for Jet City. Number 515, Cruella LaVille for Nashville Music City All-Stars. Both of these packs starting off a little bit small, with blockers taking a seat in the 888 penalty box. Cruella LaVille forced to recycle. She's going to come up against a 2 wall of Jet City blockers. 2 of those blockers in the box, 1 standing. She's forced to recycle. Meanwhile, at the front of the pack is Kat Von Devious, trying to fight her way through the center of a 3 wall. But again, that outside line left vacant yet again this jam. And it's Cruella LaVille taking advantage this time for Nashville.
LaVille averaged 29 points a game this season for Nashville, scored 27 against Blue Ridge and 42 against Tucson in their opening round bout on Friday.
And we have our first 3 points on the board for Nashville by Cruella LaVille. They look so similar, but they're wearing the different colors today.
Stability, function, durability, and superior shock absorption makes the S1 Pro Knee Pad the best knee pads for roller derby. S1helmets.com.
And we do have an official review on the track. Again, want to remind everyone at home, if I'm being goofy about it, I'm sure folks at home are a little bit. Jet City is wearing blue today. Nashville wearing the white. Nashville been wearing the blue all weekend, but today Nashville is in the white.
This is very reminiscent of a game that our producer, Double H, and I called in Asheville, North Carolina, Madison versus Nashville. And I believe they actually may have played twice that weekend and ended up switching jerseys just for comfort and less sweat. So, yes, we will do our best to keep our team straight. But just know that Jet City is in the blue with the white accent, and Nashville is white with blue. Madison and Victorian Roller Derby League in Charlotte as well, causing a little bit of confusion. 24-3, 25 minutes and 10 seconds. So just 5 minutes in so far, things going Jet City's way. Seem to have knocked that rust off after playing 2 games in the last 4 months, and those 2 coming in the last 2 days.
Indeed, Jet City also this tournament this weekend starting out a little bit slowly. Usually it takes them a little bit to find their groove, but it seems like right now that's not the problem. They're coming off the line very quickly, a change, so, and it's working in their favor.
I do also want to recognize and thank our referee crew head ref Searson, Cullen M. Fairley, Ph. Diva, Full Nelson, Der Koenig, Short Stack Attack, Chopsaw, and our human telestrator, the one telling us all the words, our referee liaison, Vanilla Vice.
And Double H, you've got some news for us.
Yes, that was just accounting for penalties, guys.
Making sure that whiteboard is straight together. Jet City is going to put out their Whoa Nelly, And Wonelli on that outside line again through the apex. Lead jammer for Nashville. It's Zip Drive wearing the star.
4 for 5 lead designation going to Jet City. And when they're getting it very quickly. They're getting lead designation before they hit turn one.
Indeed. And Jet City going to go ahead and call that off. Wonelli not scoring any points, though. She is forced to recycle. So both teams help to zero that jam.
Clean bout so far. Both these teams, well, Nashville specifically, the lowest blocker penalized team here at Wichita. They only average about 16 per bout. They had 21 against Blue Ridge and 18 against Tucson. And we're seeing the kind of the trend stay the same. They only have 7 penalties up until this point.
And this time coming off the fast girl skate start line, Lady Fury for the Music City All-Stars of Nashville and Alia Smasha for the Jet City Bombers.
Oh.
And Lady Fury.
Beethoven's fist put Lady Fury through the sport court, almost coming out of turn two.
But it's like it never happened. She earns lead jammer anyway, picks herself back up.
She is like a weeble wobble, like those things the kids punch that they just bounce back up that are full of sand on the bottom.
Indeed, Alia Smasha. There on the outside of turn number 4, forced to recycle. She tried to save it while one skate was unable to do so. Both jammers now in the pack. Lady Fury putting 5 points up on the board. Another firm, hard hit into that floor.
Cold-hearted says, anything you can do, I can do better.
Lady Fury punching through on the inside, but she is forced to recycle on the inside. Alia Smasha trapped in the center of this pack. Now recycled.
Nice inside-outside move there for Alia Smasha.
But we do have a star pass that's confirmed. That's a star pass to number 44. That's Singria that took the star, was able to make that initial pass. Nashville saw it happen, called it off. 9-point jam for Nashville. Total score so far, 24 Jet City, 12 for Nashville, and we are coming up on the 22.5-minute mark of this game.
After 9 years, Fast Girl Skates are still dedicated to making a faster you. Fast Girl Skates is proud to sponsor the 2016 WFDDA Tournament MVPs.
And number 5, Ivana Hercha, part of the regular Jet City Jammer rotation, wearing the star, and it's Ramona D. Flowers for Nashville. Pushing up against a 3 wall, 1 blocker for Jet City left in the 888 penalty box. She's being released presently. Pack situation is in the back. Jet City blocker is going to have to be aware of that. Pack does come together. Lead has been assigned. And that is Nashville. She makes her way out of the pack. Coming through, making her way around, also is going to be Ivana Hercha, able to complete her initial pass. That further apex between 1 and 2 has just really caused a gum up. Ramona DeFlowers trying to save her balance. She takes a tumble, calls it off, but earns 3 points for her trouble.
Ramona DeFlowers exceeding her typical season average for jamming scoring points. Only averages 16 per bout in the Tucson bout. She's able to score 20 points and then 18 against Blue Ridge.
Corella LaVille, number 515, wearing the star for Music City All-Stars. Number 19, Kat Von Devious in the blue for the Jet City Bombers.
Nashville has held Jet City scoreless over the previous 4 jams now.
And Kat Von Devious looking for an apex jump. She is pushed to the middle and will recycle back behind Cold-Hearted. Corella LaVille also recycled on the outside. She's going to meet a brace 3 wall, but it's Jet City earning lead jammer first for Kat Von Devious. Quella LaVille still having a little bit of trouble there in the pack. Recycled on the outside and inside, just trying to find that lane that's going to work for her. Kat Von Devious now recycled, and a penalty for Nashville. Back block is the call. Corella LaVille taking a seat in the penalty box. Power jam Jet City.
One of the highest penalized jamming teams here at Wichita. I believe they're number 2 when it comes to jammer penalties. Are the Nashville Rollergirls averaging 9.14 per bout. So you think about how many points a team would typically score on a power jam. You know, even if we conservatively say 5 or 6, you know, it's 45, 50 points. These teams are going to have to make up eventually somewhere.
Indeed, Corolla LaVille going to start this jam in the 888 penalty box. Whoa, Nelly taking the line for Jet City for a power start. Offensive blocking, singular line that fanned out as they hit the back of the wall. Effective. Whoa, Nelly earning lead jammer status very quickly. She's definitely taking advantage of this power start. Corolla LaVille having to sit almost the entire 30 seconds at the beginning of this jam. Well, Nelly tried for the inside but was pushed to the outside. She'll try again this time. Also now going to the center. And able to get through. One blocker to go on the outside, crossed over to the inside. Shoulder for her trouble. 5 points for Jet City. Meanwhile, Corolla LaVille has returned to the track, was almost blocked out in turn number 3. Was able to turn her way around for her initial pass. Wonelli with had a blocker left to go.
It was a great job by the pivot, Nasty Nikki Nightstick. The 180 kind of hook the thigh around the hip of the opposing blocker and just spin them away from the line. Cleared the opening, the outside line between turn 3 and 4 for the jammer.
Nasty Nikki Nightstick, one of the most effective blockers for her team respectively. 3 points on that jam. 8-point jam for Jet City. Taking the line is Alia Smasha. And 868, Zip Drive. Zip Drive forcing the pack to the front, out of play in the rear. But she is going to cut the track. She'll take a seat in the penalty box, giving Jet City an opportunity to earn lead jammer, which she does. And Jet City now on a power jam.
The third power jam now for the Jet City Bombers. We've got 2 cuts and a blocking to the back for Nashville skaters.
And here we see a full 4 complement of blockers just demolished by Jet City's offense. Alia Smasha not able to get around those blockers, but now we're starting to see almost a trapping offense here in the apex. It does allow Alia Smasha to get through. Points on the board, Jet City. Again, they try the same strategy, but their blockers do miss. Alia Smasha forced to recycle on the outside. Zip Drive returning to the track, taking the outside line unopposed. No one touched her at all for her to make that initial pass.
Very rare for Jet City to not get any contact whatsoever on the blocker. That 5-point final scoring pass for Alia Smasha now has created 34 points of Jet City's 47 have come off power jams.
And just like we saw in one of our games earlier today, those points that are earned off of power jams can make or break a game in a very big way.
3 of Nashville's 8 penalties are coming to their jammers right now.
Number 53, Lady Fury. And number 5, Ivana Hercha. Lady Fury lining up further back behind the line. She tries for the outside, but she is sealed in. Full blocker compliments for both teams on the track. Ivana Hercek also trying every single lane, 1 through 4. She crosses through the track. Lady Ryder recycled on the outside, but it is going to be Ivana Hercek
Phantom
and
Power,
Jet City.
Sorry, Shady. Phantom Power left the blocking wall to go play a little bit of offense, and it actually opened up the inside line for Ivana Hercek, allowing her to pick up lead designation.
4 points on the board for Jet City. Total score 51, Jet City 15, just passing the 16-minute mark. It seems like those last 5 minutes went by maybe a little bit slower than the first portion of the first period.
Well, there was a nice little stretch where Nashville had held Jet City scoreless, but conversely, it's now happening to Nashville. They've been stuck on 15 points for the last 4 jams.
Ramona D. Flowers for Nashville. I'm going to wear the star, and Kat Von Devious for Jet City this time. Kat Von Devious looking for that inside line, but she'll meet the hips of number 867, Evil Mendez, forced to recycle in that on that inside line. Meanwhile, Ramona D. Flowers, braced four wall at the front. Kat Von Devious recycled yet again, facing a Nashville 3 wall. Going into the apex.
still remained in play. A fantastic job by Jet City Bomber blockers to stay in play. Unfortunately, lead designation for Jet City was given to Ramona DeFlowers, but they've still got her in, so they're going to make her earn it again.
They are going to make her earn it again. A very difficult thing to do when you're a jammer to get resucked back up into the pack like that. But she's going to try that inside line.
They got a cutting the track call, but this jam has been called off. Cutting the track penalty on Ramona DeFlowers. So the fourth power jam now coming to the Bombers from Everett, Washington.
Now, if they're going to give her that track cut, then that would mean that the call off was an illegal call off, I believe. I'm interested to kind of have a discussion with the officials about that, but it looks like they're going to.
Double H,
please enlighten me.
You definitely want to say something.
Well, so a lot of the time, if that does happen around the same time, they will waive off any sort of additional penalty, as it depends which whistle was called first, but sometimes they're just not sure.
Yeah, it was Ph.D., and she quickly corrected her mistake. She called it off and then was like, wait a minute, you cut. So, yes, the cutting the track penalty assessed.
All right, so we are going to have.
Wait, there's two jammers
Cruella
out there,
LaVille,
though.
But there are two jammers, so I'm not sure if maybe they waived the penalty as a.
They certainly did.
If there was another factor that maybe we didn't see, Double H is going to find out for us, and we'll have that for you just as soon as we are able. In the meantime, Whoa Nelly, lead jammer for Jet City, has re-entered the track on the inside. Track cut now being assessed to Cruella LaVille. She'll take a seat in the penalty box. Power jam, Jet City Bombers.
That now will be our fourth jammer penalty to Nashville. Zero on the Jet City side is a grand slam being put up on the board by Whoa Nelly.
Wonelli going to go ahead and call this jam off. Double H, I believe you have the answer for us.
You may recall that I said sometimes they're just not sure the order. It was rescinded because Ph. Diva did believe that the call-off happened before what would have been a cutting penalty. So it was rescinded, and she was back on the track.
And there you have it.
Very fortunate for Nashville there. Unfortunately, Cruella DeVille ended up in the 888 penalty box for an additional cutting the track penalty. So clean board so far on the Jet City side for their jammers. Taking advantage of these power starts now are the Bombers.
And it's going to be Alia Smasha taking advantage of this power start in particular. And she's going to earn lead jammer by spreading those Nashville blockers out. And she re-enters the back of that pack. Brace three wall. Presented by Nashville, they are able to force her to the outside, causing her to recycle back through the apex. Meanwhile, Cruella LaVille has returned to the track. She did a little bit of star stash, and now she'll go ahead and don that star. That way she can start scoring points. Or not, Alia Smasha saying, no way, Jose. 5 points, though, on the board for Jet City.
I was kind of interested to see how Jet City was going to run that there. That would have been the second jammer penalty on Cruella LaVille. Maybe run an extra jam, maybe win it 8-4 rather than 4-0. Just kind of roll the dice and see what kind of headspace your opponent's jammer might be in.
Looks like maybe their strategy is to play it a little bit safe, a little bit more consistent, like what we were talking about earlier. That's something that they've done in the past.
Seven jams in a row now. Held at 15 points is Nashville.
And for Nashville is going to be 868 zip drive. She's skating along with Ivana Hercha. Zip drive on the outside, now looking for the inside line, but it's on the outside line through the apex. Lead jammer for Jet City and Alia Smasha. I'm sorry, Ivana Hercha. I just like saying their names. They're so fun. An attempted apex jump on the inside. Not successful by zip drive. She'll recycle and try it again. Ivana Hercha now at the front of the pack, trying to push those Nashville blockers forward and out of play.
Good communication, though, by the Nashville blockers up front. Determining which one of them is going to be the brace and which two are going to be the pendulum being swung.
And a successful waterfall, to your point, on both sides, both on the inside and on the outside. Looks like a helmet cover has been removed, and we do have a confirmed star pass for Nashville. New jammer of record is going to be Phantom Power, number 48. She has made it out of the pack. Tumble in the apex between turns 3 and 4. Ivana Hercha calling the jam off. 5 hard-earned points for Ivana Hercha there.
Big shout-out to Radar Wheels. Thank you for supporting the WFTDA tournaments. Support for this stream is brought to you by Radar Wheels. Check out the new Radar Halo Wheel.
Number 53, Lady Fury, wearing the star for Nashville. And right up on the Fast Girl Skate start line is number 19, Kat Von Devious. And it's Kat Von Devious going to take advantage, earning lead jammer for Jet City.
Singria opened a huge hole on the inside front portion of that straightaway, allowing Kat Von Devious to pick up lead.
And now at the front of the pack is going to be Lady Fury. And with a chest and a hip, maybe from her own blocker there,
yeah, cold-hearted,
but able to pop back up like she's been doing all first period. Points on the board, meanwhile, for Jet City.
Lady Fury is one of the toughest skaters I've ever had the privilege of watching skate.
Every time she hits the floor, it's like she's got springs underneath her. She just pops right back up. Kat Von Devious, 7-point jam for Jet City and Kat Von Devious.
We have a timeout being called by the Nashville Roller Girls. A good timeout to take there is a 9 minutes, 11 seconds remaining in the first period, 73-15. Our current score, Jet City over Nashville in this third place game. We are on 9 consecutive jams for Nashville where they have failed to score a point. They were doing so well holding Jet City scoreless for 4 jams. And all of a sudden, the tables have turned courtesy of 3 jammer penalties and a string. 7 out of the last 8. Lead designations have gone to the Bombers of Jet City.
Now, we're providing you guys with an awful lot of information. If you'd like to go back over this information later on for yourself, you can do that at stats.repo.wftda.com, and that will provide you with all of this lovely information that we are giving you.
It's a ton of information. I'd like to thank 5-on-5 Magazine as well as Rollline for helping put on this weekend and make it possible. Thank you.
Whoa, Nelly wearing the star for Jet City. Ramona D. Flowers for Nashville. Both jammers with very quick footwork on their toe stops, pushing forward, looking for any weaknesses in the opposing blockers' respective walls. It looked like for a moment their lead jammer was awarded, but then the arm was dropped. Lead jammer is going to be awarded, though, to Jet City and Whoa, Nelly.
Whoa, Nelly averaging 56 points a game this season, scored 34 points against Boulder County and 27 against Blue Ridge yesterday.
Well, Nelly on her first scoring pass, Ramona D. Flowers recycling back behind the pack in the straightaway. Well, Nelly took a step out, went ahead and called it off. 3 points for Jet City. I'm not sure if she was aware that Ramona D. Flowers was still on her initial pass.
Yeah, sometimes you get recycled so many times to the back of the pack. Sometimes you just kind of lose track of where everybody is. And it, you know, with a 76-15 lead, that's an okay mistake to make. You know, rather better be safe than sorry.
Indeed. I can't help but agree. Cruella LaVille now for Nashville on the outside. And she finds it. Lead jammer, Nashville. Alia Smasha still in the pack. Pack speed has increased now substantially as Alia Smasha trying to find her way through the inside on probably lane number 2, but she is forced to the inside. Again now to lane number 1. It works in her favor. Cruella LaVille forced to the inside. She'll go ahead and call that jam off. 5 points for Nashville.
Fantastic job there by Cruella LaVille, not only to get lead, but to put some points on the board just morally or It just feels good to finally get off that 15-point schneid since been on 15 points since jam number 7.
And we are going to be going into jam number 19 upcoming. Total score 76. Nashville now 20 after that 5-point jam right at the 7-minute mark. Number 868, Zip Drive for Nashville wearing the star. But out front, it's number 5 in blue, Ivana Hercha for Jet City.
And much like the beginning of this game, they're still picking up lead designation before turn 1. So the offense right off the bat and the power of the Jet City jammers really causing a problem for Nashville right now.
Indeed, I kind of felt that Nashville was taking advantage of the faster pace there for a moment. So maybe if they can force the Jet City blockers to move a little bit faster, it'll work in their favor.
Nasty Nikki Nightstick called for an out-of-play penalty. She Knocked a zip drive to the outfield of the back straightaway.
Zip drive, completing her initial pass, approaching the back of the pack. Jet City seeing her coming. And Ivana Hercha going ahead and calling it off. 2 points, Jet City.
Color Falcon plates and color Q4 boots. Check out all the colorful new goods from Adam Skates. Check out the new Pilot plates in 7 stunning colors. Adam Skates.
Lady Fury going to take advantage of a reduced number of blockers on the track for Jet City. 1 blocker in the 888 penalty box. Kat Von Devious, though, meeting a full force and the shoulder of Cole Hearted.
She has been everywhere as Cole Hearted, locking down the inside line all of the first half for Nashville.
No pack was called. Lead jammer going to be awarded to Lady Fury of Nashville.
Lady Fury now 2 for 5, 40% lead jammer percentage.
Kat Von Devious making her initial pass as pack speed increases. We do have a slight micro pack situation. 2 blockers for Jet City, 3 for Nashville. Lady Fury going to go ahead and call the jam off, trying to prevent any additional scoring by either team, especially with her taking that tumble in turn number 1, wanting to just protect those points.
Yeah, 0 points scored by either. Jammer's going to stay at 78-20 with just under 5 minutes remaining. That was a fantastic job by the lone 2 Jet City blockers out there to stay in front, keep the pack moving, and not allow Lady Fury to get her hips by theirs. Fantastic job keeping moving forward.
Whoa, Nelly this time going to start on the fast girl skate start line. And number 7, Ramona D. Flowers for Nashville. Ramona D. Flowers pushing the Jet City blockers forward, trying to push them out of play so that she can earn that lead jammer status. In the back, Whoa Nelly still trying to make her way through Nashville blockers, but it's Ramona D. Flowers doing exactly what she started out doing, earning lead jammer status for Nashville.
And it was 2 good things there. Ramona D. Flowers, not only did she get lead, but she also drew a forearm penalty on Nasty Nikki Nightstick. And anytime you can raise Nightstick's penalties up there, that's a good thing to do.
Indeed, Nightstick, one of the most effective blockers for Jet City. Mm-hmm. 4 points going to Ramona D. Flowers and Nashville. Jet City held 0.
Make sure you're ready to follow the battle for the Hydra every step along the way. Get your WFTDA TV combo pass. You're going to get all the Division II, all the Division I, plus championships for only $75. That's a deal through Montreal. $75.
$75 for 7 weekends of Derby. I know what I'm doing. Number 515, Cruella LaVille, knows what she's doing. Regular jammer in the rotation for Nashville. She's meeting a 3 wall at the front of the pack. Number 87, Alia Smasha, wearing the star for Jet City in blue. At the back of the pack, a 3 wall blocking system set up by Nashville as well. Pack spread out throughout the apex. Alia Smasha now at the front of the pack, but a jump made by
Cruella LaVille.
I'm sorry, that was just so pretty.
The landing apex jump at turn 2 for lead designation. That's going to be called the Cruella from now on. With Cruella, the great thing about it was Cruella had noticed that her blockers had pushed everybody else out sort of toward those center 10-foot tick marks along the track, and she was like, oh my gosh, so much space to the inside, and she was able to take advantage of it. Fortunate, too, that she didn't keep sliding, though, when she hit the track. Great track and skate awareness and power to stay on her feet rather than sliding under the legs of the opposing blockers.
Indeed, and now we're going to have zip drive for the Music City All-Stars. She'll skate alongside Ivana Hercha, number 5 for Jet City. Ivana Hercha going right up that middle line and then sliding through to the inside. A little bit of a tumble, gumming up through the apex. Now she's forced to the outside. She'll recycle. Zip drive also forced to the inside now and recycling. Zip drive hitting the very middle of the pack in the back, but it coming out first. Ivana Hercha, number 5 for Jet City, lead jammer.
First and last 4 jams. Lead designation has gone back to the Bombers.
Ivana Hercha trying to save her balance. She does take a little bit of a tumble. She'll be forced to recycle back into the apex. At the front of the pack, zip drive. 2 more blockers left to go. She takes a tumble yet again, but pops right back up. and is able on the outside line to make her way through for her initial pass.
Sia wouldn't want to be. It was doing everything she could to make sure she hit zip drive out of bounds at turn three. Unfortunately, finally had to let her go as she was dangerously close to being out of play.
Jam is called off. Cole Hearted again preventing Ivana Hercha from moving through on the inside line, forcing that call off. We do have an official review on the track.
Nashville.
And that is, again, from Nashville. I'm intrigued by this official review.
Well, you can't take it with you, and there's a minute 10 left. So it's a good it's good to take it, even if you just want to use it as a timeout, which
they are doing, according to our head referee.
I always find something to challenge, whether it's a block, a multi-block, something like that. Because you think, as a coach, you think, well, they'll at least talk about it for 45 seconds to a minute. And if you can explain yourself for those 15, 20 seconds, you've already had a minute and a half. So,
coaches everywhere, coaching advice from Marone.
But it's good to use it. We've seen teams this weekend take them with you to halftime without even using it as a timeout. So if you're going to use it, go ahead and use it. Yeah, so fantastic job there by Nashville. The second clock stoppage they've been able to use so far this period, 82-26, a minute 10 remaining in our period clock. This game is for third place here at the Wichita Division II playoffs. Coming up next, we have Brandywine versus Blue Ridge, the 3 versus the 7 for the first place seed. I'm sorry, fourth place, 4 seed Brandywine, 7 place Blue Ridge for the Wichita Championship.
We are ready to go. Kat Von Devious on the fast girl skate start line. Lady Fury for Nashville. Lady Fury, again, going to try that push the pack forward strategy. She hops through on the outside, takes a hit, pops back up, going into turn number 2. At the back of the pack, Kat Von Devious forced to recycle back behind a 3 wall. She tumbles in the middle of the stretch, but she gets back up. Now she's at the front of the pack. 2 blockers left to go. Is Kat Von Devious.
That was the first time this period that I've seen Cole Hearted actually stray away from the inside line, and it allowed Kat Von Devious to get through her. And now, a cutting the track penalty on Kat Von Devious.
Yep, cutting the track penalty on Kat Von Devious. So not only do we have lead jammer for Nashville, but Lady Fury on a power jam as well.
Kat Von Devious still on her initial pass as well when she is finally released from that triple eight penalty box.
Lady Fury going to try again on the inside, forced to recycle. Blocker contact there from Electrical. And 5 points, first 5 points for Lady Fury. In a little while. But Lady Fury, if anybody's going to take advantage, it's her. Going to try for the outside this time, but she's coming up against Singria. Singria, one of the more seasoned blockers for Jet City, proving it there, forcing Lady Fury to recycle to the outside. Kat Von Devious now has returned to the track, and she has the star in her hand. So if you're watching at home, that star now has been passed to number 44, Singria, for Jet City. Lady Fury realizing that that's happened, taking the advice of her coach, going ahead and calling that jam off. 10 points for Nashville and Lady Fury.
Nice little spark there at the end. And I'll even tell you, even over the last, call it 7 jams, Nashville's jammers were able to pick up lead 5 of those 7 times. Don't have a whole lot of the points other than that 10 point. They had 6 points up until that 10-pointer there by Lady Fury, but at least they're able to control what happens at that point. Even if you're not getting the productivity, it's still a good feeling to determine that, in fact, you are in charge of where the bout goes at that point. In those same jams, 6 points being scored by Jet City. So a good job of not only improving your score there, but holding Jet City to a minimum.
Indeed, and I'm enjoying this low penalty count as well for this game. It does seem like there are blockers in the box an awful lot, but if you look at the grand total of everything, it seems well within what's considered a normal range. So we'll have a little bit more information for you after the half. We are at halftime. We will see you back here in 14 minutes. And we're back, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for coming back and joining us here on WFTDA.tv. We're watching the 2016 International Division II playoffs here in beautiful Wichita, Kansas. My name is Shady Hawkins, and I'm joined by Marone. Marone, talk us through what just happened in the first period between Jet City Bombers and Nashville Music City All-Stars.
Well, it was kind of a game of a short streak of success there for Nashville, followed by a very long streak of success for Jet City. We went over that long spread where Nashville was held to 15 points, and as a matter of fact, we kind of did the math over halftime here that Nashville was held scoreless for 17 out of the first half 24 jams. Figure that out into a percentage, that's 70% of the jams that Jet City's defense was able to hold Nashville scoreless. And not only is the defense being successful for the Jet City Bombers, but they're doing it very clean, very little penalties. This is a team that averages 30 blocker penalties per bout, and right now they're sitting on 12.
12 blocker penalties or 12 penalties total?
I'm sorry, 11 blocker. We have one jammer sent to the penalty box. So 11 blocker penalties, they averaged 30, and they were able to hold a team scoreless for 70% of that first period.
So Jet City changing up their game a little bit, being a little bit more aggressive with their defense, perhaps, but also very solid and clean, something that we were a little concerned about early on in the tournament. We weren't really sure like where kind of the energy was for Jet City, but apparently they were saving it for today.
Well, I'll tell you what, it was almost like in their first two games, there was no sense of urgency on Jet City's part to succeed in whatever they were doing. We're seeing it from the first start now, coming through halftime, as the Jet City and their coach are having a twerk off there in front of their team bench. That's the intensity I like to see in a derby team. But now they're doing things with a purpose. And unfortunately, on the other side, it looks like Nashville is searching for something to do. They're trying to commit to something, but they're not able to get set in what they're trying to do, but they're constantly searching for that opportunity to kind of lock it down.
So when we were talking earlier at the beginning of this game about consistency, would you then say that Jet City has found that level of consistency that they needed?
Oh, I absolutely think they found it, and it shows on the scoreboard, 82-36 here as we head into the second period.
We're working on getting that getting those points back up on the, there they are, points for you all at home. As we wind halftime down.
And conversely, Nashville played lights out in the second half yesterday in their game against Blue Ridge. So we'll see if they can kind of turn it back up to 11 here in the next 30 minutes. Only a 46-point differential. So it's still within striking distance. Nashville's one of those teams that, if you're going to blow them out, you need to do it early, because you can't let Nashville hang around. And that's what happened in the first game of the weekend for them when they were playing Tucson Roller Derby, and they came back and won in the last minute. They came back yesterday against Blue Ridge, and they only had a late upper 20s-point deficit, and they're still hanging around now, even though the success isn't on their side.
Well, our period number two has gone ahead and started. It's Corella LaVille skating for Music City All-Stars, Will Nelly for Jet City. And up at the front, it's going to be Cruella LaVille earning lead jammer status. First jam, second period of this game.
Nice job by Nashville locking it down at the back of the pack there as they all slowly roll past turn two. Really doing a good job of holding in Will Nelly.
Will Nelly looking like she's putting a hand over her face, perhaps maybe an incidental contact to the nose. Jam being called off.
Well, and Cruella LaVille saying, I didn't call it off. And she's kind of wondering why that jam was called there, and she's kind of looking around for answers. It doesn't look like she's going to get one, but
the crew head referee has indicated to the track.
Oh, we may have blood.
That we may have blood on the track. So in that circumstance, the officials will go ahead and call that jam off. We cannot continue with there being a biohazard on the track, so we are getting the medics out there to go ahead and take care of that for us.
Yeah, Dirk Koenig is standing over there, so waiting for the medics.
It's actually not blood on the track for once. It is actually a loose tile on the sport court.
Ah, oh. I see. Equally as unfortunate.
Safety first.
Safety first. We're getting track maintenance out there to take care of that. If you'd like to join us in the meantime in our discussions, you can join us at Twitter, Hashtag talk2WFTDA. That's talk the number 2WFTDA. And you can post all of your playoff thoughts, of course, on hashtag WFTDA.
Well, we had
playoffs, and we've just been confirmed by our alternate referee, Vanilla Vice, who's getting a lot of love on himself on Twitter today, that there is also blood on the track as well as a loose tile.
Loose tile and blood. This has been Lightning Slim, I believe, tweeted in earlier today at Talk to WFTDA. So much blood this tournament.
So much blood, especially in one game. And I believe that was the Kansas City game earlier. Lots of blood this weekend, but that's okay. We're all tough here. We can handle that. Those of you at home, you're getting a nice view of our inside whiteboard and of all the lovely codes and penalties that exist out there. Multiplayer's going to be one of those penalties that has been heavy this tournament.
One third of the penalties so far called in this contest have been for multiplayer blocks, cutting the track number two, but not to the extent nearly as we've seen the multiplayer blocks called.
And we're going to have a new jammer on the line for Nashville. That's Phantom Power. Going to try something a little bit different for Nashville. Number 87, Alia Smashia in the back of the pack. And Phantom Power doing work for Nashville. Lead jammer.
Two for two. Lead designation in the second period for Nashville.
And on the outside, unchallenged is Phantom Power. 5 points in her first scoring pass. Meanwhile, in the middle of the pack, we've got Alia Smashia trying for the inside line. Now she laterally moves to the outside. Gnarly Quinn stopping her. Still Gnarly Quinn to go in the apex, but she is out of play. Gonna have to let Alia Smashia go.
Nice job there by Nashville's pack, not only holding back Alia Smashia, but kind of running a little bit of interference for their jammer. We said in the first half, it's not often that you see Jet City not touch a jammer coming through the pack, and that just happened again for Phantom Power. She was able to shoot around the outside of turn two.
Lining up now on the fast girl skate start line, Ivana Herchin, number 5 for Jet City, and Ramona D. Flowers, number 7 for Nashville. For those of you just joining us, Jet City in blue and Nashville in white. Ramona D. Flowers pushed to the inside and forced to recycle alongside Ivana Hercha. Ivana Hercha colliding a little bit with Cole Hearted. And it's going to be Ivana Hercha on the outside. Lead jammer, Jet City.
Hercha able to muscle past that foremost blocker for Nashville to get that lead designation.
Ramona D. Flowers now having removed the helmet cover. She's holding the star in her hand, and we do have a confirmed star pass, and that is going to go to Cole Hearted. Cole Hearted now the jammer of record for Nashville. Jet City and Ivana Hercha saying, I want none of it. We'll call it off with 5 points on the board for Jet City Bombers.
Huge thank you to Adam Skates. Adam Skates just got a lot more colorful at hashtag ColorMeAdam. Color Falcon plates and color Q4 boots. Check out all the colorful new goods from Adam Skates.
Triple Eight penalty box is empty with Cruella LaVille lining up for Nashville. Kat Von Devious taking the outside line for Jet City. Kat Von Devious now going to try the inside. Doesn't work for her. She goes to the outside, but it's too late. Cruella LaVille, lead jammer for Nashville. Both of these jammers really turning on the Jets now, trying to do their best to make their way all the way around to the pack. Pack speed increasing as well. Apex jump in turn four. Cruella LaVille calls it off. 4 points, Nashville.
It's the second apex jump now by Cruella LaVille in this game. Fantastic field of vision. Not only she had to skate around the inside hip of her own blocker coming out of turn three, and then jammers usually take those wide and then cut in to get that apex jump. She never left the inside line.
No, she did that in one clean, smooth motion. Lady Fury now giving it a go for the Music City All-Stars. Alia Smashia back on the line for the Jet City Bombers. And Alia Smashia now looking for the outside line. She finds it. One blocker left to go, though, before she exits the engagement zone. Lady Fury now completing her initial pass as she exits the engagement zone.
It was good track awareness by Lady Fury there. She saw two skaters fall, so she just got up, and rather than going all the way back and trying to earn it again, she just jumped back on the track for the two, no pass, no penalties.
Indeed. 2 points for Jet City. Again, we see that pack speed increase. We see the jammer speed increase. We're coming up on the 25-minute mark. Jet City 89, Nashville 53.
When you need to roll quick, think quick. Quick bearings, where precision meets performance. Roll faster, further, and smoother with precision bearings from Quick.
Number five, Ivana Hercha. On the outside, able to scoot her hips around Nashville defense. And again, we're going to see Phantom Power wearing the star, who has now removed the helmet cover. She has it in her hand as she's trying to go up the center line. We're not sure if she's attempting to initiate a star pass or not. Looks like no. She just did it to be sneaky. She'll go ahead and put that star back on so she can start scoring. Jet City calling the jam off. 4 points up now on the board as we cross the 90 mark. 93 for Jet City, 53 in Nashville. An even 50-point differential between these teams. 40. No one told me this job would have math. Kat Von Devious now going to line up on the fast girl skate start line for Jet City Bombers. 8:68. Zip drive for Nashville. Kat Von Devious trying for the inside line. She is unable to do so, so she's going to try the middle this time. Zip drive, going to look to do the exact same thing and try and take advantage, but it is Kat Von Devious who will take advantage first. Lead jammer for Jet City.
Four of the last five jams, lead designation gone to Jet City, and Jet City unable to pull away again from Nashville. We're looking at that 40-point deficit.
And again, we're starting to see the pack speed increase, and we're seeing the jammer speed increase.
That was a nice job by Nashville taking the inside line, not allowing the jammer Kat Von Devious to get through on that inside line anymore. Devious had to kind of deviate away from the inside line at turn one. She ended up losing her footing. Skates came out from underneath her, had forced to call that off before Zip Drive was able to pass any of the Jet City skaters. So great job there by Nashville, not only speeding it up, but holding that inside line.
And holding Jet City to only 1 point for that jam. Cruella LaVille now for the Music City All-Stars. Alia Smasha, number 87, Jet City Bombers. Cruella LaVille trying a little bit of a straightaway jump. Going to recycle behind Razor Wrecker. Alia Smasha now looking for the outside line. That's been her friend the last few jams. She is now forced to the inside by Nashville. And shoulder to the outside. No pass, no penalty. And out front is going to be Alia Smasha for Jet City and lead jammer, while Cruella LaVille is recycled to the inside. Alia Smasha on her first scoring pass, now on the outside.
It's a nice job by Cruella LaVille there, seeing that the inside line was open as the swinging pendulum of Nashville blockers swung the Jet City blockers up to the outside of the back straightaway.
Again, Jet City having to settle for only 1 point. This increased speed not doing them any favors.
Yeah, 42-point lead right now for Jet City, 95-53 with 21:54 remaining in this contest. And again, you know, we talk about it. Nashville has proven they can be a second-half team. And Jet City is letting them hang around here, 42 points.
Ivana Hercha this time for Jet City Bombers. Ramona DeFlowers trying to go up the middle for and waterfalled out to the outside by Jet City Bombers. She's going to be assessed a cutting the track penalty. Ramona DeFlowers on her way to the penalty box. Power jam now for Ivana Hercha and Jet City Bombers.
And I do believe that is the first penalty issued in the second period here, Shady.
I'm not 100% sure, but we are having the jam called off now.
We have a downed Jet City skater at turn one. It is the jammer, Ivana Hercha. Did not see the hit. She's holding her right shoulder as we officially take the official timeout because of this injury. Would like to thank 888 for sponsoring our penalty box all weekend. Helmets, pads, wrist guards. 888 has got you covered. Protecting Derby since day one. Their helmets protect against rotational violence with MIPS patented brain protection systems. Looking at my chicken scratch in my notebook here, Shady, lead designation has gone to Jet City five times this period, and really not a whole lot to show for it. The differential now isn't any real difference than it was at halftime here. So, you know, Nashville is staying with it. What Nashville's doing better this period, though, than they did to start this bout is even if they're not getting lead, they're getting their jammer out. Whether that's coming from a hit by Cole Hearted on the inside or a swinging pendulum block, you know, it's getting established and they're able to use that now as jammers.
Ivana Hercha, of course, now up and off the track. She will take a seat for three jams, as is the safety protocol. Woe Nelly now on the line for Jet City. Jet City trying to push to the outside. She's unable to do so. She's going to take the inside line this time.
Does Nashville have a jammer?
Nashville's
in the penalty
jammer
box, yes.
Is in the penalty box, but we have a multiplayer call on Woe Nelly. Not something that you see on a jammer very often, but it is being assessed. She'll take a seat in the penalty box, which will release jammer for Nashville, Ramona D. Flowers.
Yeah, I forgot Ramona was in there for the cutting the track. Yeah, she used tried to go for the assist off of another skater, got the multiplayer block picked up infraction.
And Ramona D. Flowers is going to look to make her initial pass, trying to do it as quickly as possible. Jet City now going to be looking for the penalty kill.
Nashville had an opportunity there to drop back and trap the goat a little bit. If you're not going to play offense at the front of the pack, go ahead and drop back and try to catch a blocker and give your jammer 20 feet of space at the front of the pack.
And it is Jet City with the penalty kill. Ramona D. Flowers still on her initial pass, unable to get out of the pack. Woe Nelly being forced to recycle. Ramona D. Flowers, one blocker left to go at the front.
Oh, and dumped by the foremost skater for Jet City, number 80, Beethoven's Fist.
It's going to be Woe Nelly now at the front of the pack. A multiplayer call penalty on one of the Nashville blockers will allow her out for an initial pass, but she is not lead, and it's Ramona D. Flowers' lead. Going to go ahead and call it off, preventing Woe Nelly from scoring any points.
Strong defense there. Missed opportunity kind of for Nashville. In the grand scheme of things, it could have dropped back and trapped that goat, played offense at the back of the pack. When you do that, you create a 20-foot gap. The players up front are now out of play. They would either have two choices, either let the jammer go, you get lead designation that way and you're on a scoring pass, or you risk taking a penalty for an out-of-play block. Either way, it's a win-win for Nashville. Just need to be executed a little better. They did play offense, which is good, though.
Kat Von Devious starting off for Jet City, and Lady Fury trying to ride a little bit on Kat Von Fury at the beginning of the jam. Lady Fury, though, finding the outside line all on her own. Lead jammer, Nashville.
3 for 8, Lady Fury this jam, this game, 38% for 19 points for Nashville.
And with a little bit of an apex hop to the outside line, she makes her way through the pack. 4 points on the board for Lady Fury.
Using every bit of the back straightaway was Lady Fury, inside, outside, back, inside to out before calling it off. 4-point pass. Lady Fury 57-95 in favor of Jet City. 18-15 remaining in this third place game here in Wichita.
We're going to start this next jam with no one in the 888 penalty box. Full complement of blockers for both teams. Alia Smasha on the Fast Girl Skate start line for Jet City, and it's going to be Phantom Power wearing the star again now for Nashville. Nashville dipping into their reserve jammer base just a little bit. Phantom Power at the front of the pack. Two blockers left to go through the apex, forcing Jet City to stretch that bridge out. One blocker now left to go, and she is forced to the outside by one skate. She'll recycle back all the way into turn number one. In the meantime, Alia Smasha trying to work her way up the middle of the back of the pack, and now that the two walls have met, there's a little bit of a cluster. We're going to wait to see if she can take advantage, but she's still on the inside, shouldered by Phantom Power. Phantom Power, one blocker left to go. That's Singria that's going to try and push her to the outside, hips around, and it's going to be Phantom Power, lead jammer for Nashville.
3 for 3 now. Oh, but unfortunately, Nashville lets the Alia Smasha out on the pack on her initial pass as well, so it's going to be a quick hit and quit here for Nashville's Phantom Power, hopefully. Well, we'll see.
And we saw that pack speed increase yet again. Nashville always able to capitalize, it seems, when that pack speed does increase. 0 points on the board for Jet City. We're waiting to see points. And that's going to be 3 points now for Nashville.
a 35-point deficit here, 95-60, 16:40 remaining in this contest. Huge thank you to Fast Girl Skates. This year they are sponsoring the 2016 WFTDA Tournament MVPs. If you think you have an idea of who that should be or who it's going to be, go ahead and shoot us a message at Talk2WFTDA.
Hashtag on Twitter. And it's Cruella LaVille for Nashville at the front of the pack against a three wall. And she's able to move through on the outside. Cruella LaVille, lead jammer for Nashville. A lot of frantic screaming now on the track.
Oh, and a power jam now to Nashville is a forearm penalty going to be assessed to Ivana Hercha. It was given to PH Diva via another official, so a little late in the call, but it was getting called eventually. So a power jam now for Nashville, four lead designations in a row. We'll see what Nashville can do with this.
Ivana Hercha a little bit confused by that call, but she's going to go ahead and take a seat anyway, maybe costing her a little bit of time and allowing Cruella LaVille a little extra time to get her way around to the pack. Only three blockers on the track. And now playing offense is Nashville, trying to get Cruella LaVille through. Three blockers to go. Cole-hearted, giving a little bit of an assist, but then dropping back passively, allowing Cruella LaVille to just get beat up and pushed to the outside, but we are going to get a direction of gameplay penalty for their trouble. One blocker left to go, Razor Wrecker, unable to stop Cruella LaVille. 5 points that took quite some time to add. Penalty kill for Jet City. Ivana Hercha now returning to the track, making her way through her blockers for her initial pass. Cruella LaVille almost being pushed to the outside, but she saves it by escape. She'll call it off. 4 points, 14-point jam for Nashville, and we have a timeout called by Jet City.
Wow. And just like that, Shady Hawkins, Nashville has woken up here in the second period. Four leads in a row, outscoring Jet City over those last four. Well, they've held Jet City scoreless over the last five jams, has Nashville, and they've outscored them in that time 21-0. If you're going to put away Nashville, you got to put them away early. You cannot afford to let Nashville hang around here. That 14-pointer, the highest jam this period. We had a 10-pointer in the first half for Nashville.
Both teams probably going to do everything that they can right now to take advantage of this timeout, even though it's Jet City that called it, wanting to kind of stop that momentum that Nashville is building. But Nashville going to try and take advantage of this rest period as well.
You know, Cruella LaVille is having a fantastic game for Nashville Roller Girls. 6 of 11, 55% lead percentage, 32%. 32 points, has a plus-minus differential, +8, the leading scorer for Nashville. I would have liked to have seen that time out there, maybe just throw her back out, but now we've got Zip Drive on the line for Nashville and Wo Nelly for Jet City.
And there are whistles, and it's Zip Drive going to earn lead jammer status. It is a no pass, no penalty, therefore she will continue on. Lead jammer, but during the confusion, Wo Nelly able to make her way out of the pack as well, both on their first scoring pass.
Nashville might have got caught at the back of the pack. They certainly did for 1 point, but 4 points to Zip Drive.
And 1 point to Jet City. We'll see if the speed, if Nashville can maintain this speed. If Nashville can maintain this speed, they may be able to close this gap little bit by little bit. Next, to give it a try to close that gap even further, is going to be Lady Fury on the Fast Girl Skate start line. And number 87, Alia Smasha for Jet City in blue. And Alia Smasha forced to the inside by Cole-hearted. She'll recycle all the way back behind number 718, Incredible Hull. Alia Smasha now going to try the inside of the pack. Again, we have both walls clammed together in the apex, but coming out smelling like roses is going to be Lady Fury. And Lady Fury now on a power jam, track cut being assessed to Jet City. And Alia Smasha going to take a seat in the 888 penalty box.
An 18-point deficit right now that Nashville is facing. Oh, good job there by Lady Fury of keeping that one skate out of bounds as she was taken to the outfield by the foremost blocker for Jet City.
Lady Fury looking there for a moment to Cole-hearted for a little bit of assistance, but she didn't need it. Swoop-de-woo S maneuver there on the outside. 5 points for Nashville.
13-point deficit, and it'll still be the initial pass for Smashia.
Smashia standing in the penalty box. We're waiting on her release. Lady Fury getting knocked down on the outside. She'll be forced to recycle back into term number one. Alia Smashia has been released from the penalty box. She's going to look to try and complete her initial pass as quickly as possible. She falls through and is now completed her initial 3 points on that pass only for Lady Fury due to no pass, no penalties. A lot of skaters on the ground.
Wow, an 8-point jam there for Lady Fury, taking the deficit to just 10 points, ladies and gentlemen. What a fantastic outburst of productivity here for Nashville.
If you've been watching any of the rest of the games today, you know that right now is the time that you absolutely need to be watching this. If you still want to catch the last 12 minutes of this game, you can do so for $12.99 at WFTDA.tv. Make sure you get on there and watch this. So many close games today. D2 for the win. Ivana Hertchen now on the line for Jet City. She's going to earn lead jammer going out of turn number one on the inside for Nashville.
Lead picked up by Ivana Hertchen. The first time over 8 jams, lead designation has gone to the Jet City Bombers.
Nasty Nikki Nightstick pushing Phantom Power of Nashville to the inside twice now in a row.
Trying to get around Nasty Nikki Nightstick is Phantom Power.
Ivana Hertzer forced to recycle back at the back of the pack. Nashville now trying to form a three wall. Nasty Nikki Nightstick helping her jammer out in the back. We have an initial pass completed by Phantom Power. Jam is going to be called off by Jet City. 5 points on the board for Ivana Hertcha, holding Phantom Power and Nashville to zero that jam.
Triple eight and Spank Alley, proud to support the WFTDA and their international 2016 playoff season. Thank you for your continued support, Triple Eight and Spank Alley.
Both blocker compliments for these teams are going to start with one blocker in the Triple Eight penalty box. On the fast girl skate start line, numbers 19, Kat Von Devious for Jet City Bombers. And number 515 in white, Cruella LaVille for Nashville Music City All-Stars. Pack not moving at all right off the line. Cruella trying to go through the center, now going to go to the outside again, trying through the center, but it is a firm brace three wall that's going to try to waterfall her out. They are unsuccessful in committing to that. Back at the front of the pack, Kat Von Devious able to pirouette around using her hips. Lead jammer going to Jet City and Kat Von Devious.
And we talked about it earlier. What they're doing better this half is Nashville is when they're not getting lead, they're still getting that jammer out. Cruella LaVille right behind her, only about a quarter of a lap behind her. 3 points put on the board for Jet City. It takes them to 104-86 for Nashville. You know, they're not getting lead, but they're getting those skaters out, and they're forcing either the call off quick or very minimal damage on the points.
We've just passed the 10-minute mark as Jet City has passed the century mark, 104 to Nashville's 86. Whoa, Nelly jamming for Jet City Bombers. Ramona D. Flowers jamming for Nashville Music City All-Stars. Whoa, Nelly trying for the inside line. She's forced out and forced to recycle back into the middle of the pack. Ramona D. Flowers choosing the middle line. She is meeting resistance against a truck and trailer style three wall. On the outside, Whoa, Nelly looking for a lateral movement to the inside, and she'll find it on her toe stops. Whoa, Nelly, lead jammer for Jet City. Star cover has been removed by Ramona Flowers. We're looking to see if we have a confirmed star pass, which we do. That's going to be number 226, Taro Bite. Now the new jammer of record for Music City All-Stars.
Taro Bite took the star a couple games ago versus, I want to say it was versus Tucson. Came out of the penalty box, scored 10 points for Nashville in that epic comeback on that Friday game. So not a stranger with the star, just fun to see.
Definitely, and definitely a little bit different. We saw Cole Harder take the star a couple of times already in this game, so trying to change it up a little bit as we approach the end of the game. Zip drive now, going to skate for Nashville. 87, Alia Smashia for Jet City Bombers. Zip drive forced to the outside by Nasty Nikki Nightstick. She'll recycle back behind two wall of blockers, two blockers in the Triple Eight penalty box for Jet City. Zip drive again on the outside, force to recycle, and it is going to be Jet City's Alia Smashia earning lead jammer, but she's forced to recycle back through the pack to recomplete that initial pass, even though she does have lead jammer designation.
Oh, nice job there by Nashville's pack. We said it.
And we have a forearm on
one of the blockers. Yeah,
the pivot.
Cold-hearted.
For a moment there, because it was being issued by PhD, but I thought it might have been on Alia Smasha, which would have been just absolutely devastating for her, having just earned lead jammer, but it was not. No points awarded on that jam.
22-point advantage, 108-86, 7.5 minutes remaining. We have an official timeout. Searson is gathering the captains and coaches. Give them a quick little speak. Lady Fury is going to don the star for Nashville when we get started back up. Looks like it's going to be Ivana Hercha if the rotation stays intact for Jet City Bombers. Again, hanging right there, 22-point disadvantage.
Lightning Slim, you're absolutely right. Nashville's core skill apparently refusing to die. Refusing indeed.
Is another epic comeback in the books for the Nashville Roller Girls. They came back and won on the final jam against Tucson Friday afternoon. This one getting very interesting with 7:39 remaining, 108-86. Both teams still have two timeouts, two official reviews left. So this could end up being like a college basketball game or a pro basketball game where the last 30 seconds take 2 hours. But we're going to have a winner at the end of it, and that winner is going to take home third place here in Wichita.
They
Double
are.
H, do you have an update?
I sure do. There is a skater from Jet City in the box, and we don't happen to have a recorded penalty for her, so there's a little bit of penalty accounting going on with the officials.
While we're taking the time to do that, we want to remind everyone, as we just did, took a look at Twitter, responded to one of our posters. So if you'd like to send us a little bit of a message, you can talk to us at hashtag talk to WFTDA, talk the number 2, WFTDA.
The skater in the penalty box appears to be Sia Wouldn't Want to Be A. And it looks like Sia is going to stay there.
Two blockers now in the pack, in the 888 penalty box for Nashville, one for Jet City. Jet City taking advantage, earning lead jammer. Right off the line is Ivana Hercha. And on the outside line, coming around, that's number 53, Lady Fury. Lady Fury really putting the pressure on Ivana Hercha, forcing her to call it off. Ivana Hercha, 4 points placed on the board for Jet City.
We got a clarification on the penalty on Sia Wouldn't Want to Be A. I believe it was a misconduct has now been assessed to Sia Wouldn't Want to Be A.
One blocker on the track for Nashville now. Two blockers in the box, one standing. Number 48, Phantom Power, put on the line, and Kat Von Devious able to pivot around, making quick work of the single blocker. Lead jammer for Jet City. Phantom Power forced to the inside. She'll recycle all the way around. Now we have two blockers on the track, three blockers on the track for Nashville, three blockers on the track for Jet City. Phantom Power still trying to work on her initial.
And here's that sense of urgency again for Jet City, starting to turn things up. It got down to a 20-point deficit. I'm sorry, an 18-point deficit at its closest. And now starting to nickel and dime their way back through the lead here as that jam gets called off by Kat Von Devious.
Kat Von Devious, two additional points on the board for a 7-point jam for Jet City. Sometimes nickel and diming is exactly what you got to do. And if that's what you need to do, as the clock winds down to the 6-minute mark with three timeouts per team, do you start thinking about when you're going to need to start taking those timeouts if you're Nashville?
Either now or the very next jam. Nashville has now been held scoreless over the previous six jams, being outscored 23-0 over those six jams. So yes, time management now with 5.5 minutes remaining and three timeouts, you're going to need to be able to use those.
Coella LaVille going to take advantage of an outside line open. Lead jammer for Nashville. A little bit of a change of momentum there. Wonelli still trapped behind a three wall, and an apex jump by Coella LaVille.
Really?
Really. It just happened. I saw it with my own two eyes. Five points.
A power jam. We got a power jam now as a cutting the track penalty assessed to Wonelli. And right now the doors are open for the Nashville Roller Girls.
Singria attempting to knock Coella LaVille out of bounds through the apex, but she's able to save it. 5 points up on the board for Nashville. She's going to go through for another scoring run.
Oh, and no touch to the outside. No touch is bad touch for Jet City as Cruel Lavelle found the outside line on the back straightaway.
And we're seeing both sets of blockers prepare, but only sending up one blocker for an offensive assist. I guess they're thinking that since Cruella Lavelle has a little bit of speed, she's got enough momentum. But in that circumstance, would have served her well to have maybe a little bit of extra blocker assistance because she's been pushed to the outside, and she is going to be awarded a track cut for Cruella Lavelle. She'll take a seat in the penalty box. Now a power jam opportunity for Jet City to try and make up for everything that Cruella Lavelle just did.
She is going to be able to get out of the AAA penalty box. She sat down with about 34 seconds left on the clock. Still on her initial pass, though, is Wonelli. She is now through, eligible to start scoring points. We have an 18-point deficit here, Shady Hawkins.
That pack stretch that just happened, courtesy of Jet City in the back in turn number three, allowed for Wonelli to come out because it pushed those front blockers into an out-of-play position. Wonelli now facing a three wall of blockers. Jet City choosing not to play any offense. Nashville recycling Wonelli because of it. Cruella Lavelle now released from the penalty box. She'll step back on the track. The jam will come now to its conclusion. 18-point jam for Nashville, 5 for Jet City Roller Girls.
Wow, 124-120, and we now have a timeout being taken by Nashville. Good use of the timeout right there. A 20-point deficit after that 18-point jam by Cruella Lavelle. And you know what? I know she just jammed. It might be worth it to throw her back out there again. With less than 4 minutes, you still have – oh, no, Jet City, I'm sorry, took that timeout.
I'm intrigued by Jet City taking their timeout as opposed to Nashville. I think maybe because Nashville had that momentum, they were wanting to kind of keep it going, and they were afraid that maybe if they took a timeout, it would stifle that momentum. So Jet City, seeing that momentum, now taking that timeout, when otherwise we were just talking about how Nashville should be doing it. So tables have turned.
I don't know what momentum Jet City was seeing. That was just one jam out of the last seven. They've been held scoreless for the last six jams.
I think maybe they got a little intimidated by the apex jump, the power jam. So maybe the... maybe it just kind of all seemed a little too much at once.
No.
Jet City taking that timeout, but I mean, we're not on the track with them. We can't possibly know what they're thinking, but it happened, and we're back. Zip drive for Nashville. And on the outside, earning lead jammer for Jet City, going to be Ivana Hurchin, number 5 in blue.
Nashville needs to get out of the pack here, break free of that engagement zone. They do so after the successful star pass to Cole Hearted. We'll see how Jet decides to run this. They're looking at their coach, Trey Latrash. They're going to call it here as soon as Zip Drive gets close to the penalty. Nashville needs to quit skating because they're just killing time, speeding up.
4 points on the board for Jet City. Nashville held to zero. We're going to reset. We are now under 3 minutes left in this game, and a timeout has been called.
We'll see who called it, because we're not sure almost at this point who's going to call a timeout. Timeout two. Can't see who we're getting pointed.
I don't think
yes, it's going to Nashville. So a timeout now being taken by Nashville. A 24-point advantage for Jet City. Unable to put away Nashville, have been the Bombers from Everett, Washington, and now there is the urgency for both squads. We'll see how Jet City handles this. We already know Nashville's been in this situation this week. We'll see how Jet City decides to play the remainder of these three minutes. Two clock stoppages still on the table for Nashville and the head coach, the one wearing the A, Mr. Cal. Done a good job this weekend as well with his Nashville Roller team.
And with that, we are going to end the timeout. Skaters already on the track for both of their teams. Ramona D. Flowers wearing the star for Nashville Music City.
Huge thank you to Derby Central and Bruce Skate News, as well as RollerCon.
Alia Smasha wearing the star for Jet City. Alia Smasha forced to the inside by Nashville defense. Nashville defense walling up in the back, dropping one blocker to form a bridge, but now they are able to put together a moving cube. One blocker for Jet City dropped to the back in an attempt to help Alia Smasha. Alia Smasha finding the outside line, and she's going to earn lead jammer status untouched on the outside for Alia Smasha.
Give the Mexorcist a gold star for participation there. It was the offensive move from the outside to the inside that freed her jammer, enabling her to get lead designation.
And a little hop there by Alia Smasha across the apex. She's going to earn 4 points, call the jam off before Ramona DeFlowers can make it to the back of the pack. And we're going to have
an official timeout. It does not appear to have been designated to anyone yet.
I believe I'm waiting for the signal from the NSO. It is a timeout. Still waiting to see who took that timeout.
Nashville.
Nashville did take that timeout.
So 2:20 remaining. Here's what your plans are if you're Nashville. One, get lead. Two, call a jam off with at least 32 seconds left so those four whistle blasts don't carry over to 29 seconds remaining on the game clock.
Three, question mark, for profit.
You have a great opportunity here for Nashville. 28-point deficit brought up by Jet City right now. Jet City playing strong, but Nashville used to being kind of in this role, playing from behind. A very clean second half for Nashville, only two jammer penalties compared to the four they had in the first period.
Lady Fury now going to be jamming for Nashville, and she'll toast up her way through on the outside line. Nashville with lead jammer status.
Oh, could this story be written in front of our eyes for Lady Fury and the Nashville Roller Girls? Unable to hold in the other jammer, though. Kat Von Devious.
Kat Von Devious out on an initial pass, meeting the hips of Singria. She is able to make her way around those hips. Lady Fury calling it off with impunity. 4 points on the board for Nashville, and they are going to go ahead and use that official review. Whether or not they're going to actually review anything or not is left to be seen, yep. But I believe it is most likely going to be, are calling for the other team's captain slash coach.
All righty. Regardless of how this bout turns out, the clock management for Nashville has been superb in this game. And I'm finally glad to say that for any of these teams, not these two teams particularly, but I'm talking about Wichita in general. We've seen some questionable clock management and timeout usage or non-usage, to be more specific. But Nashville is playing this perfectly. We'll just see, though, if they can get into this 24-point differential, Shady.
Indeed, and I'm really intrigued. We'll hear from Searson, the head referee.
Gretchen.
Well, Searson was going to make the announcement. He has decided to reconfer with his reffing crew here.
Talking about that time management that we were just going over route train of thought, if you will, something that we see higher level teams take advantage of, D1 teams, time management, making use of those penalties, making use of those official reviews. So seeing a little bit of a higher level strategy here at our Division II tournament.
Well, for a long time, Nashville's been one of those strong D1 teams, as we're going to get, well.
Looks like Searson is going to call the captains and coaches back to the line to have a discussion with them.
It does not appear the microphone was working, so Vanilla Vice is making his way over here. He'll be talking to Double H as the captains and coaches get filled in on everything that happened.
And we have a microphone. We're unsure if over the feed we were able to hear that, but Double H, I believe you have the results of that for us?
Yes, Nashville requesting a cutting the track call against Jet City's jammer in that last jam. And although the officials agree it was pretty close, they're going to err on the side of a no call.
Pretty close isn't going to cut it here.
When in doubt, no call is the call.
I do like the call here by Nashville, though, throwing Cruelle Lavelle back out on the jammer line. She's been the most successful jammer with 50 points, 6 of 14 lead. And she's got lead one more time. Cruelle Lavelle, lead designation for Nashville. Now the pack has got to do everything they can to hold back the Jet City's Wonelli.
Wonelli having removed the star from her helmet cover. She had it in her hand. One skate to the outside, unable to save it. As Corella LaVille, she'll recycle all the way back. Attempting a star pass complete. Star is now in the possession of Jet City skater number 80.
Beethoven's fist has not jammed this game, so interesting strategy, Cotton, as we've got a Cruel Lavelle with 5 points already, a 24-point differential going into this jam, knocked out of bounds on the turn three.
Beethoven's fist forced to recycle to the back. Corella LaVille also forced to recycle. It is going to be a no pass, no penalty as she enters the track in the middle of the apex. Corella LaVille with one blocker. Wonelli left to go. Way out of play.
Out of play call being assessed to Jet City, and that jam gets called off as Beethoven's fist. No, we're not. No more timeouts left for Nashville, but we have 38 seconds, so we are going to get another jam. A 10-point jam for Nashville's Corella LaVille, and you know what? Cruella may have to dig deep here because she has been absolutely killing it for the Nashville Roller Girls. We're going to see who Nashville throws out there.
Nashville.
Looks like it's going to be Zip Drive.
Indeed, Nashville throwing out Zip Drive in the white.
14.
Timeout called by Jet City. We are on the dais are astounded at this choice.
You're up. We have a 14-point advantage for Jet City, and Jet City has now taken one of their clock stoppages, their final timeout. They still have an official review. We'll see if they use that maybe after this jam too. But a 10-point jam for Cruel LaVille, and this only helps. This only helps Nashville. We're looking, you know, you go back to, we're looking back to the game, and I'm kind of looking at both Shady and Double H, Victoria versus Gotham. At the Division I champs last year, Gotham kept using timeouts, but it eventually they had the momentum, but Victoria kept using timeouts, and it allowed Gotham to keep fielding Bonnie Thunders one right after another. That just happened for Jet City, and if I'm Nashville, I give the star back to Cruella LaVille.
Nashville not going to do that, though. They are going to keep Zip Drive wearing the star. I wonder what kind of a plan they have in action. Limited blockers though on the track for both teams. Only three blockers on the track for Jet, two blockers on the track for Nashville. Perhaps that has something to do with their choice. Zip Drive though, pushing forward to the front of the pack. She's recycled to the outside. Ivana Hertzschiff for Jet City.
And a nasty Nikki Nightstick forces the cutting the track on Zip Drive. So lead designation still open for Ivana Hertzschiff.
Cole Harted, the last blocker to beat, and she does it. Jet City lead jammer Ivana Hertzschiff being told to call it off by the coach as the penalty clock reaches zero. Unofficial final. Jet City Roller Girls 132, Nashville Roller Girls 118. Again, we are in an unofficial final. Jet City just absolutely excited. And Marone, your head is in your hands.
Such an odd series of events. Nashville played that perfectly. They had to use their two timeouts. You look at jams 20. We just had 26 jam second period, okay? After the Cruel LaVille cut in jam number 22, they used a timeout after Zip Drive jammed. And then Ramona DeFlowers jammed, and they used another timeout. Lady Fury jammed, and they used their official review. Nashville did everything perfectly, Shady Hawkins. And then what happens? Jet City gives them a gift and takes another clock stoppage for them with a 14-point advantage and 17 seconds left on the clock. I mean, I know the jam's going to start regardless, but you gave Nashville a chance to strategize and get set and get ready to try to close that 14-point gap. It just wasn't in the cards, though, as the jammer Zip Drive cut the track coming out of turn one. Nashville has nothing to be disappointed about in this game, but a fantastic job. Jet City played just hard enough down the stretch in order to preserve that win.
Indeed, they did. They're taking their victory lap now. The score has been made official. Jet City Roller Girls 132, Nashville Roller Girls 118. Jet City clinching that third place spot. I know they wanted it really bad, especially coming into this tournament as the one seed, wanting to leave in the best position that you possibly can, and they did so. They were able to execute. Coming up next, is the game that everyone has been waiting for. It's the game to determine the number one and number two place as these teams go into championships. Brandywine facing Blue Ridge. That game will begin at 6 p.m., so make sure that you stick around. I've been Shady Hawkins, and for Marone and myself, thank you for joining us. We'll see you at 6 o'clock. Hey.